This is an example of a membrane reactor and a simplified version to demonstrate the properties. And the idea of a membrane reactor is if you can preferentially remove or add a component through the walls of the reactor, so you have walls that are porous to at least some of the components, and so the wall is a membrane. And there's some selectivity as to, for example, which components you remove. So in this case, we're looking at a dehydrogenation reaction of A going to B plus hydrogen using a plug flow reactor whose walls are permeable only to hydrogen. For example, this might be a palladium membrane as the walls of the reactor. We feed in just pure A to the reactor, and it's a reversible reaction. And so this is the motivation for trying to remove hydrogen from the products and therefore shift the equilibrium further to the right. So we have a forward reaction and a reverse reaction. The feed is at 20 atmospheres. So, of course, as we go to higher pressures, the equilibrium is pushed back towards reactants. As we go to higher pressures, we are increasing the rate of reaction because of higher concentration, and we're providing a driving force for hydrogen to go through the membrane. So we're going to assume there's no pressure drop through the plug flow reactor. We assume it's isothermal. We can certainly relax that assumption just by adding in another equation for the energy balance, but just to demonstrate the behavior. Total reactor volume, 150 liters. And then the flow rate of hydrogen through the reactor walls. So this is hydrogen only. And say we're modeling this similar to what behavior might be seen for a palladium membrane, where the flux is proportional to the concentration of hydrogen to the 0.5 power. So this flux, so this is moles per volume per time. And so we've basically built into this equation what's the surface area per volume of the reactor. And for a different shape reactor, this number would be different for the same wall. So we've basically included the surface area per volume. And then the question is, what's the molar flow rates look like as a function of volume? And so we have the rate of reaction, and essentially we're just going to write down mass balances. Change in flow rate of A respect to volume is minus R, right? So R is, in this case, minus R means that A is reacting, the forward reaction, and then A is reforming reverse reaction. And B, of course, is very similar, except it's positive R. And then the flux of hydrogen, again, it's positive R. And then it's minus the flow rate per volume through the membrane. So essentially, we're going to solve these equations simultaneously, which means we have to write the rate, K forward, concentration of A, K reverse, concentration of B, concentration of hydrogen. So we have to have equations for the concentration. So the concentration of A would be the mole fraction of A times the total concentration. Total concentration, if we assume ideal gases from ideal gas law, is just P over RT. And then there's similar terms for concentration of B, and likewise for concentration of hydrogen, same form. Mole fractions are related to the molar flow rates. So the mole fraction of A is the molar flow rate of A over total flow rate. Mole fraction of B, molar flow rate over total. Likewise for mole fraction of hydrogen, same behavior. And the total flow rate is just the flow rate of A plus the flow rate of B plus the flow rate of hydrogen. Now, the units, moles per liter per minute for the rate. And so we're going to work in those units and use atmospheres, and the gas constant is going to be 0.08206. So this is atmospheres, liters, moles, Kelvin. So essentially, then the problem is almost finished. We have the equations that we can put into a differential equation solver. In this case, we use polymath. So we put in the equations, and the equations calculate concentrations, put in, of course, the various constants that we need for the rate constants and for the pressure and the temperature. And then we solve from volume equals zero to volume equals 150 liters. And so I've copied in the polymath program where the flow rate of A, notice the stoichiometric coefficient here of minus one, initial conditions for A, the volume, initial value, of course, is zero at the beginning. We're going to integrate to 150. And then flow rate of B, its stoichiometric coefficient is positive. And flow rate of hydrogen also has this term because of the membrane reactor. So the rate written in terms of rate constants, concentrations, the flux through the membrane, concentration of hydrogen to 0.5 power. Here are the rate constants and the pressure. So total concentration from ideal gas law is just P over RT, temperature. We need the concentrations for the rate expressions, and we get them in terms of mole fractions and the total concentration. And the mole fractions we get from just the flow rate. So flow rate of A over total flow rate is the mole fraction of A. And so if we now ask it to solve, we can plot the behavior. And here's the output from the polymath program. We're plotting the flow rates on the y-axis. So these are molar flow rates. This is the reactant A, flow rate of A. This is the product B, and this is the hydrogen. So of course we form B and hydrogen 1-to-1 stoichiometric ratio, but as the hydrogen concentration increases, then we have a bigger driving force for hydrogen to permeate through the membrane. And then as the reaction slows down, we're permeating hydrogen through. That allows the reaction, of course, to not stop completely, but it's certainly slower. And so the hydrogen molar flow rate moving down the plug flow reactor goes through a maximum and now decreases as the rate that it's being made from the reaction is slower than the rate that can permeate through the walls. And so membrane reactor then has potential to allow us to shift the equilibrium of the reaction by continuously removing hydrogen.